You don't get it, do ya? It's not what you say, it's not what you do, it's just in the way you do it. Not that kind of fool, yeah. Spent so many days thinking of ways that I could break it to ya. Not saying it's not you, it's me.
Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video. As you can tell, I am very dressed up today. We're going to be doing a little tutorial, a little Valentine's Day tutorial. This look is inspired by Jennie from Blackpink. This is one of the many looks that she wore during the Blackpink the show. And when I saw this look, I knew I had to recreate it and I thought it was perfect for Valentine's Day. It's really simple. It looks like it's a lot. I promise you, it's really, really simple and super easy to do. But before we jump into the tutorial, I would like to thank Ana Luisa for sponsoring today's video. And if you guys haven't heard of Ana Luisa before, I have worked with them in the past and I'm obsessed with their pieces. They are a sustainable jewelry brand based in New York. So they offset 100% of their carbon emissions right from the sourcing of the material to the disposal of their pieces and making them carbon neutral. So like I mentioned, I have worked with them before in the past and I feel so happy and grateful to work with them again because I truly love the style of their pieces and also the quality of them. I'll quickly show you the four pieces that I picked up this time around, and I feel like they're very on theme with Valentine's Day. So we'll first start off with the earrings that I'm currently wearing. These are the puffed heart hoops. The original price is $68, but with the site-wide sale they're having on right now, this is $58. I think these are so stinking cute. I love how it's sort of like a statement because it's all gold, but it's still quite dainty. And I actually have the matching puffed heart necklace, which is super cute. You guys know my obsessions with hearts, so you guys know I'm gonna be wearing this one so much, and especially in February because of Valentine's Day. And the next piece that I'm wearing is the heart moonstone necklace. I believe this is a collaboration with an influencer, but originally it is $87, and with the sale that's going on right now, this is $74. I love this one. I think it fits this look so perfectly as well. I love like the sort of vintage vibe it has. I feel like this one is probably going to be my daily necklace because it's just so dainty and so small, and I feel like the vintage vibe suits my aesthetic really well. I also picked out another necklace. This is the Joy heart necklace, also $87 but now $74 with the sale that's going on. Had my eye on this one for so long now. I think it's so cute. So it has the heart padlock with the heart key. This is also a very dainty piece, a very simple piece to wear every day as well. I feel like I'm going to be going back and forth with the moonstone heart and the Joy heart necklace. And the last item I picked out is the Olivia adjustable ring. This is originally $57 and now it's down to $49. You guys can kind of tell my jewelry preference. I love very dainty, simple pieces. And I know I'm just going to be wearing this ring all the time. I also like how it's adjustable. So if I'm wearing different rings that day, I can switch which finger I am placing it on. Very easy to adjust. And I love the little simple pattern that it has. So this is the last piece that I picked out. So again, Ana Luisa is having their 15% off site-wide sale for Valentine's Day. They have so many more styles on their site, all starting from $39. So no matter your preference or your style, I'm sure they'll have something for you. So thank you again to Ana Luisa for sponsoring today's video, and let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial. So I'm first going to start off with primer, and I'm going to go in with the Supergoop Unseen Sunscreen. This is my SPF, but it also does work as a really great makeup base because it has more of a silicone texture to it. And for my foundation today, I'm going to be taking the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Hydrating Foundation. I'm wearing the shade Light 70W. Because I do want a little bit more coverage for today's look, I'm going to take a foundation. The finish of this is really nice. I've been using this one pretty much every single day because of my project pan. But did you guys watch the show? I wasn't going to watch it just because it was like $50. But when they showed the little snippet on James Corden, it was so good. I'm like, okay, if this performance is so good, imagine the concert. So I was like, okay, I'm just gonna support the girls. $50, it was so worth it. It was $50 New Zealand, by the way. But I think it was so worth it. There were so many unique performances and just so different from their usual stage. Like, you could tell they put so much effort into this concert. I feel like Jennie's solo, her new rap part, that was like really cool. I really love them dancing in water, I did not expect that. Like, that was crazy. And them just performing a lot of their B-sides that we haven't seen before, I loved it. So good. For my concealer, I'm going to be taking the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer in the shade Almond. You guys know that this is my favorite concealer. I'm just going to use this to cover up muskin. I've been breaking out a lot around my cheek area, which is sort of uncommon. I usually break out around my chin, I feel. I'm going to be taking some of my loose powder just on my sponge, and then I'm going to tap off on the back of my hand, and I'm just going to use this to set down my base. I feel like Jenny had a really matte base, but it wasn't like too matte where it was flat. When I saw this look, I was like, okay, I need to recreate this because it's so simple, but it's like really pretty. And I feel like it was really nice for Valentine's Day because she had the roses. I feel like that was her theme. She wore like two outfits that had roses involved. I'm just gonna take my setting mist. This is the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Acid one, just to set in the powders. So now I'm gonna do my brows. I think I'm just gonna speed through this part, but I'll film it anyway because I've had questions about my brows. I don't do anything special. My brows are not the best, you know, but I'll just keep the camera rolling, but we'll speed through it. Alright, so brows are on. I did try to make them a little bit longer and straighter because Jenny's brows are quite long, but I tried. You know, I'm not really great with my brows. So with that being said, let's move into the eyeshadow. It's very, very simple. We're gonna start off with eye primer. I'm just taking the Kaleidos Tone Activator Primer. So the main palette that we're going to be using today is the ColourPop That's Taupe palette, and I actually did a Blackpink versus Twice makeup IGTV. For the Blackpink side, I actually used the That's Taupe palette, and I was doing more of like a Jennie inspired look. So I feel like Jennie wears a lot of cool tones, and what's great about this look is that she actually posted so many photos of this look, and she even closed one eye so I could see it even clearer. And it does look like there's a lot of taupey shadows, but a little bit of warmth on the lower lash lines. So the first shadow I'm gonna go into is Pebble Beach. This is a really nice neutral taupey tone. And we're just gonna sweep that onto our lids. And for the lower lash line, it seems like she has more of a warmer tone. So I'm gonna go into the Nude Mood palette from ColourPop, and we'll take this shade. We'll take this shade actually. This one is called Bare to Wear, and I'm gonna take it on a very fluffy brush because I just want that blown out on the lower lash. Like, not too defined, but just some color, you know? I'm gonna go into this shade called Bed Rock, and we're gonna use this shadow for our wing. It looks like she just has like a very soft smoky wing, so we'll try and do that. I'm gonna focus most of the wing at the outer third. I'm gonna tight line my upper waterline, and then for my bottom waterline, I'm gonna take this one from ColourPop. It's called Honey Dude. It's just like a really nice nude eyeliner, and this will just help open up the eyes. So I'm actually gonna go into this shade here called Slated, and we're gonna pack that on at the inner third of our eyes. This has a lot of like little specks of glitters, which is quite similar to what Jenny's wearing. I And just to add extra dimension, we're gonna take the Urban Decay Moon Dust Shadow in Space Cowboy. This one is super dimensional. We're gonna place that right on top of Slated. And it's just going to give more little micro glitters and just make it even more sparkly. Kind of feel like she has more chunkier glitters in there, so we're gonna go in with one more product. I know, a lot of glitter. I'm gonna take the e.l.f. liquid glitter in the shade Flirty Birdie. It's a little bit warmer, but the reflex are more silver, so we're gonna mainly pick up that. Okay, we'll use this little tiny brush, so I'm just gonna take a little bit and then we'll pack that on. Maybe I'll use my finger. Oh yes, yes, this is the perfect finishing touch. Yep, yep, that's what I wanted. This has like more chunkier glitters. Yes, okay, now we're seeing the sparkle come through, yes. I'm hopping back into the Nude Mood palette. I'm gonna take this shade called Wink Wink. It has like a light gold reflect. And we're gonna place this at the inner corner of our eyes and also just at the center on the lower lash. And now it's time for the Red Gems. I feel like that is sort of the star of the show. I got this little pack from Spotlight, which is my local craft store. And we're gonna place that in our inner corners here. And then she also put one out here at the tip of the wing. Cute. I wish they were kind of smaller, but that's good. That's fine. I like it. The eye look is coming together. Now what's left is just lashes. So I'm going to be wearing these ones from Petite Cosmetics in the style Hana. I did cut them, so that's why they're really, really short. We're just going to place them at the outer corner. It does seem like she's wearing a very natural strip lash, but I don't have any natural lashes that look like that. The mascara that I'm going to be using today is this one from Hemish. It's their Smudge Stop Mascara. And we're only going to be putting mascara on our upper lashes because Jenny didn't put any on her lower lashes. Like, her lower lash line is quite bare. So these are the eyes all done. The look is slowly coming together. We're gonna move back onto the cheeks now. I'm gonna add a little bit of bronzer. It doesn't seem like Jenny has any on, but I'm just going to add a little to give my face a bit of warmth. Just a light wash. I'm taking my Kaleidos bronzer. I'm just gonna add a little bit here. Yeah, that should do. Just a little bit of, you know, sculpt to my face. As for blush, she does have like very rosy cheeks, so I'm gonna go in with this Super Shock shadow from ColourPop in the shade Cruel Intentions. I feel like it has a strong red base, so we're gonna just take that on my sponge. So I am gonna skip out on highlighter because it doesn't seem like she has any highlight on her face. I feel like it's pretty matte. So we're gonna move into the lips now, which is the last step. It's like a rosy mauve-y tone, like a pinky tone. I have been loving the Odin's Eye lip products recently. Maybe that's a bit too dark. No. I think this color might be the best option. It's not really that similar to her lip color, but I think it goes well with the look. This is the Velvet Lipstick in Red Cherry. Alright you guys, so this is the final look. I feel like I definitely have transformed. This headband I purchased from Spotlight, which is the same place that I got the little rhinestones. As for my top, this is actually my prom dress from how many years now? Maybe 9 years ago? I am shocked that I still can't even fit it. It is a little bit tight. It is cutting into my love handles a little bit, but it fits and it works. Harry and I actually last night just like safety pinned these little roses on the chest area to add to the Valentine's Day look, and also inspired by Jenny as well. But I really love how it turned out, and of course my jewelry is Ana Luisa. Everything is Ana Luisa. I think it fits perfectly with this look. So again, thank you to Ana Luisa for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget they have their 15% site-wide sale for Valentine's Day. If you want to pick anything up, I'll leave links down below in my description box. Let me know what you guys think of this look down below in the comments, and also if you did enjoy this tutorial and found it fun to watch, please give it a thumbs up. I would appreciate it so much if you did. But yeah, with that being said, you guys, that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. 'Cause I know